Welcome to Great Hymns of the Faith. My name is John Fraser. I'm your host. We are going to begin our program today, as I always like to begin each and every program, with a great hymn of praise. And this particular hymn, we're going back, to about 1796. Perhaps it's based on Psalm 148, verse 1. Praise the Lord from the heavens, praise Him in the heights above. The hymn, Praise the Lord, ye heavens, adore Him. Austin Miles, 1868 to 1946. He attended the Philadelphia College of Pharmacy and the University of Pennsylvania. However, in 1892, he abandoned his pharmacy career and he wrote his first gospel song. He became editor and manager at Hallmark for 37 years. He's the author of our hymn, a favorite of many. It's called In the Garden.
Tells me I am His own.
Cleland B. McAfee, in 1903, wrote the words to a hymn following the tragic death of two of his brother's daughters who had died of diphtheria. Perhaps he had in mind this verse from Isaiah 40, verse 11. He gathers the lambs in his arms and carries them close to his heart. The hymn, Near to the Heart of God. Spirit of the Living God is a hymn by Daniel Iverson that was inspired by a sermon on the Holy Spirit during an evangelical crusade in the 1930s. The lyrics call upon the Spirit of the Living God to fall fresh on me. Enjoy the hymn.
Spirit of God.
Rhea F. Miller was the wife of Dr. H. V. Miller, one of the general superintendents of the Church of the Nazarene. After her husband's death, Mrs. Miller taught piano and traveled all around the area in her little gray Nash coupe teaching piano. She had a special mission in life, and that was to get into pastors' homes and teach their children how to play the piano so that they would have something to contribute to the church when they became adults. She would offer to teach these children for free and hope to make up the difference with her other students. She was a very inspirational woman and made a deep impact upon many lives. She was very positive, always smiling, full of encouragement, and always enthusiastic. I hope that you enjoy her hymn, and it's called "I'd Rather Have Jesus."
I'd rather have Jesus than silver or gold. I'd rather be his than have riches untold. I'd rather have Jesus than houses or lands. I'd rather be led by his nail-pierced hand than to be the king of the vast domain, or be held in sin's dread sway. I'd rather have Jesus than anything this world affords today. I'd rather have Jesus than men's applause. I'd rather be faithful to his dear cause. I'd rather have Jesus than worldwide fame. I'd rather be true to his holy name than to be a vast domain, or be held in sin's dread sway. I'd rather have Jesus than anything this
The gospel song, Bringing in the Sheaves, was composed by Knowles Shaw the year 1874. 4 short years later, 1878, Knowles Shaw perished in a tragic train crash in McKinney, Texas. I hope that you enjoy his hymn.
Bringing in the sheaves.
Sowing in the morning, sowing seeds of kindness, sowing in the noontide and the dewy eve, waiting for the harvest
and the time of reaping, we shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves.
Sowing in the sunshine, sowing in the shadows, fearing neither clouds nor winter's chilling breeze.
By and by the harvest and the labor ended, we shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves.
Edward Hopper graduated from New York University in 1839 and Union Theological Seminary in 1842. He was ordained a Presbyterian minister in 1842 and served pastorates in Greenville, New York, Sag Harbor, Long Island, and at the Church of the Land and the Sea in New York City. He authored the hymn, Jesus Savior, Pilot Me.
Jesus Savior, pilot me.
Jesus Savior, pilot me over life's tempestuous sea, unknown waves before me. Hiding rock and a treacherous shoal, chart and compass come from thee, Jesus Savior, pilot me. As a mother stills her child, thou canst hush the ocean wild. Boisterous waves obey thy will when thou sayest to them, be still. Wondrous sovereign of the sea, Jesus Savior, pilot me. When at last I near the shore and the fearful breakers roar, 'twixt me and the peaceful rest, then while leaning on thy breast, may I hear thee say to me, fear not, I will pilot
thee. Anna Waring, 1823 to 1910, She was raised a Quaker, but was baptized into the Church of England in 1842. She mastered Hebrew as a young girl to be able to study Old Testament poetry and daily read the original Hebrew Psalter throughout her life. She is the author of our next hymn called In Heavenly Love Abiding. Caroline Maria Noel, 1817 to 1877. She was an invalid most of her life. However, God gave her the strength to write, and she was most productive in her writing. And it was Caroline who composed the words of the hymn, At the Name of Jesus. That's all the time we have for today, folks, but I trust that you did enjoy the hymns that I was able to share with you, and I hope that, good Lord willing, that you'll be able to join us next week for more great hymns of the faith. God bless.